Every year, several tertiary institutions in the country pass out millions of graduates with different qualifications. These, however, spend a better part of their lives trying to secure jobs, while many settle for odd jobs as they try to make ends meet. Employers say the reason Ugandan graduates are unemployable is because they lack hands-on skills. Mwesigwa adds that many tertiary institutions have failed to upgrade their training to the current trends of science and technology, hence many of the graduates cannot satisfy the current market demands.
Skill development, skills upgrade is what is required. We have been having a mismatch at some moment. I think the only thing here and elsewhere was to get a university graduate. But when we come into practical things, you find many of them are a bit wrong. That's why you are saying the skills development needs to be implemented, even if somebody is a PhD holder, master's holder, a first degree, they should add on a specific skill to be able to align, especially with us, who are investing heavily into production processes that are actually capturing modern technology.
Institutions have been advised to up their game and prioritize skills development. This was during a meeting between the Uganda Business and Technical Examinations Board, DUBITEB members, and industrialists, plus other stakeholders.
We are already in collaboration with the Nakawa Vocational Institute, at Chambogo here, UPIC. We have collaborated with the Tira Motors, the gentlemen and women trying to manufacture buses and other cars.
In the same meeting, GUBTEB officials revealed that they are currently encouraging the modular curriculum to ensure that everyone can acquire a skill. This way, the country can be able to fight the widespread youth unemployment. A year ago, UBTEB rolled out the modular assessment guide as part of the implementation of the TVET policy of 2019. This was intended to ensure that trainees acquire the desired skills that can enable them to attain employment. After the engagement, the board went ahead to meet with trainers at the Lugogo Vocational Training Institute. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.